DIVERIMPACTS project is all about crop diversification to increase the diversity in space and time in arable but also in vegetable cropping. That means breaking up monocultures and if there are rotations to increase the length of rotations or spatially to introduce, for example, intercropping, that means two crops at the same time in mixtures, but also undersown legumes. Or it can be multiple cropping, that means two crops in one year. So these are all different kinds of measures that we apply in the project in two ways. So there are case studies and there are scientific trials. So in this video, I'd like to present you our scientific trial here in Switzerland. The aim is here to diversify an organic rotation with a lot of legumes. As organic farmers want to introduce more and more legumes in their rotation to reduce fertilization. And also stockless farmers who don't have animal fertilizers, they make use of legumes. But the problem is that if you have a high share of legumes in a rotation, then soil pathogens come into place. So in this trial, we have two main goals: to test whether with a high share of legumes in the rotation, if soil pathogens increase over time, and if this high share of legumes can reduce fertilizer needs. This is the second year. We have the results from the first year where we compared barley fertilized with pea barley unfertilized. And what we have seen is that the mixture was gaining more yields than the pure barley. And the interesting thing was, if we have barley which is unfertilized, we have quite a low quality. But if we grow the barley in the mixture with pea, we have the same quality than the barley which was fertilized. So the barley is actually profiting from the pea. So as this is only the second year, we have 2 years more to come, where we want to compare faba bean and faba bean with oat intercropped. And then the year after, we're gonna have maize, silage maize in all treatments, but in the diversified treatment undersown with white clover. And in the final year, we're gonna have an extended soil analysis for soil microbes, the microbiome, and also earthworms, which will be very interesting to see the cumulated effect over 4 years.